I completely switched from editing videos on Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve 17 for 30 days, and boy, have I got some thoughts about that. In this video, I'll share my experiences with it, what I learned, the highs and lows, and what I plan on using to edit videos in the future. By the way, if you are new here, my name is Anton Wong. On here, I help you understand, unlock, and unleash the power of video, so if you haven't yet, hit subscribe. Now, before I get into my experience of my 30-day experiment with DaVinci Resolve, I first want to talk about why I decided to do this. I first heard about DaVinci Resolve's editing capability back in 2015 and how it's becoming more and more like a capable non-linear editor, or NLE for short. I knew that it was used as an industry standard color grading software, and I had heard of them releasing a free version that included most of the same features and functionality of the pro version. At that point, I was just starting to learn Adobe Premiere Pro and Avid Media Composer in broadcast school after spending 3 years editing Final Cut Express videos. Yeah, that's right, Final Cut Express. So learning a new software didn't seem like that big of a deal to me. I downloaded the software, but since at that time, the amount of online tutorials was just not very abundant or existent at all. So I figure I would rather spend my time learning the existing software like Premiere and Avid. Now, in the years that it's been purchased by Blackmagic, DaVinci Resolve's video editor has gotten better, cheaper, and more widely used. People were sharing how they got faster renders, better color control, easier workflow, and most importantly, to all Premiere users, fewer crashes. I knew that DaVinci was only going to continue gaining traction, so after 5 years of using Adobe Premiere for all my video editing, I decided to finally download the free version of Resolve and start learning how to use it this year. However, unlike my previous attempts at trying to learn Resolve, I wanted to make sure that I used it, so I decided to only use Resolve for all of my video editing needs for 30 days, and it was really something. On day one, I had made my first mistake of downloading the beta version of Resolve 17. You might be wondering, why is that such a mistake? Well, sometimes the beta version of software can come out kind of buggy, but more on that later. Now, I had already started watching YouTube tutorials on how to use the software since my last attempts at learning it involved my attempt at learning through trial and error before giving up. So I was not repeating that mistake again. By the way, if you guys want to check out some tutorials that I was using, I recommend you check out Casey Ferris, Billy Ripka, and Wakaz Kazi for Resolve tutorials. However, the best way to learn is not through a tutorial, but through an actual project, just doing it. So my first video up for editing was my review of Anchor.fm. Now, the way Resolve works is fairly similar to every other NLE out there. You just bring in your clips into the project window before bringing the clips onto your timeline using the in and out points, or the whole clip and just bringing that into the timeline, and you trim and manipulate the clips within that timeline. However, the layout and workflow is a bit different from Premiere or Avid. For instance, for importing, it just points to the clips, kind of like just saying that is the clip that I want to use, as opposed to doing a full import and transcode like the way Avid does. It also establishes something called a Resolve database, where instead of setting your project files and everything you want wherever you want, it has everything into a central location known as a database. So if you want to start a new project on a different disk, like a new external hard drive, you have to establish a new database. Also, the project files are a .db database file, so just be aware of that, because I don't seem to be able to just double click on the file. You can really only go into DaVinci Resolve and then open the project file from there, at least from what I can tell. Let me know if I'm wrong. But once I figured that out, I encountered another problem, and that is the software's function buttons. Now, when learning a new software that accomplishes basically the same task, the instructions, short keys, and buttons are usually in different places. The default keyboard for Resolve has the insert and overwrite tasks assigned to F9 and F10, which is really far from where the hand usually rests at the J, K, and L keys for playback and pausing and rewinding, and also the I and O keys for setting your inpoints and outpoints, like almost every other NLE uses. However, you can set your own keyboard shortcuts and customize it to however you would like your keyboard to act. And once I did that, I was finally able to finish my Anchor.fm review. And you know what? Hey, it came out pretty all right, I think. Now, week two came with a different struggle: learning motion graphics in Fusion. Now, Fusion is Blackmagic's 3D and 2D effects and compositing software that they sort of integrated into DaVinci Resolve, and I decided that week two would be the week that I would try to learn it. And it just so happened that a friend of the podcast, Jade Vincent, or Jade Can Dance, as she's known on TikTok with over 2 million followers, posted on one of her Instagram stories saying that she's making YouTube videos. I figure that making her an intro would be the perfect opportunity to finally learn motion graphics in Fusion, so I asked her if she was interested and she was on board. But she didn't give me any instructions on style or length or really anything at all. And that actually made it more difficult to make something when you can literally do anything in Fusion, which really kind of overwhelmed me. So I figured I would just try to follow some YouTube tutorial about how to make 2D motion graphics and just follow that tutorial to a T on how to make the logo animation, and bing bam boom, I would be done. I was wrong. You see, Fusion, like I mentioned, is a 2D and 3D compositing tool that is used in films like Gravity and Ant-Man and TV shows like Breaking Bad to assemble all the CG elements into a live action shot. The biggest difference between working in After Effects and working in Fusion is that Fusion is a node-based compositor and not a layer-based one like After Effects. That basically means that instead of putting stuff down on a scrapbook layer by layer, you're basically telling the computer what you would like these objects to do. Now, that makes a lot of sense when you have a whole bunch of 3D elements and you don't want to have to sort through a whole bunch of layers, you just want to look at a node tree and just figure it out from there. But I was so not used to that. I couldn't figure out how to do a simple logo animation after carefully following one of the few YouTube tutorials I could find. On top of the tutorials being a little hard to follow, I just struggled to wrap my head around how nodes work. Well, actually, I did figure out how nodes work. I think it's more of just I didn't figure out which nodes do what and what names of the different nodes and how you connect them. So, yeah. But I had told Jade that I'd give her an intro by a certain date, so I cheated by downloading an After Effects logo motion graphics template and importing it in Jade's photo into it and tweaking a few parameters before exporting it. I then took some clips from her past YouTube videos, compiled them and the logo animation into the DaVinci edit tab, did some keyframe animation, and sent that to her. Now, she seemed really happy with the results and she didn't know what to expect, and you know what, I would have to say it looks pretty good, but I'm still disappointed that I couldn't figure it out how to use Fusion. I'm really gonna try to learn how to learn Fusion going forward. Another issue I had was trying to figure out how Multicam edits work. I had a Zoom interview with my friend Dax Brule for my podcast and wanted to be able to switch between the two shot of the both of us and the single shots of each of us. I tried making different shots by duplicating the one shot, putting them on separate timelines, changing the cropping and sizing for each, and then making them all compound clips. I was also working with two different audio clips that I needed to sync up manually, and since the audio, time codes, and start times for all of the different clips were all different, the multicam edit just it didn't work. I couldn't figure it out. After a couple of hours trying to figure it out, I decided to just give up on the whole endeavor and manually place and sync all of the shots and files one by one on the timeline and then trim each layer to switch between the different shots. Multicam editing would probably work better if I had thought through the process a little bit more, but yeah. We'll get them next time, boys. Now, weeks 3 and 4 weren't too different from the first 2 weeks, but I was getting a little bit used to how the software works, and my editing was actually getting a little bit faster because of that. But remember how I mentioned that I made a mistake getting the beta version? Yeah, that really did in fact bite me in the back. I had no idea how much the software would crash in the beta version. I would be working on something very simple, just like trimming clips on the timeline, and then all of a sudden, boom, it would just freeze. The program would freeze and then automatically it would shut down. I distinctly remember this because I sometimes forget to save after working for like 20, 30 minutes, and I don't have a screen recording of this when this happened, but it looked something like this. Now, I don't have full confirmation that it was in fact the beta version of the software that was making it crash and not my computer not being able to keep up with the project, but my computer has a 6-core Ryzen 5 with a 3.8 megahertz GPU with 16 gigs of RAM and a graphics card with 6 gigs of VRAM. And also, the projects were basically just 1080p MP4 files and a little bit of simple keyframe animation. I don't think my computer was the issue here. So hopefully the full version of Resolve 17 is released with all the bug patches and I don't you know, have to encounter this issue anymore. Last thing I remember from the challenge was learning the color and fairlight audio tabs. This was one of the more enjoyable parts of the challenge. DaVinci's color tool is obviously best in class and industry standard. I was only able to really just scratch the surface on how to use it and trying to learn how to use their LUTs and try to learn how to use their color grading software, but it's just so much more comprehensive than Premiere, and I really look forward to using it more. When using Fairlight's audio, it did almost feel like I was using a digital audio workstation like Pro Tools or something. I do wish, however, that there were more plugins that were pre-installed in there that I could use, but overall it was pretty good. And that brings me to the end of the challenge and my thoughts on Resolve. After reflecting on it, I've come to learn that trying to learn any new software requires patience and practice. Of course, there's the aforementioned technical issues, but of course that's also just gonna require even more patience. Now, moving forward, I'll probably continue to use Resolve alongside Premiere and other software. The color tab will definitely need to be explored more, and learning how to make 3D comps in Fusion will be my next goal, and just really trying to figure out how nodes work. I can now see why people avoid switching editing software or any new software that people get used to in any industry. Even though filmmakers and video creators like to look at every single new gear or every single new camera of the week, we scoff at the thought of changing software that just works for us because reasons. But I think that if we do take the time and concerted effort to learn a new tool, we might just like what it can do and learn more about ourselves in the process. That is, as long as you don't try to learn a new software completely in the beta version that is very buggy and I'm still a little bit salty. And if you would like to see another video where I challenge myself to make 5 videos a week for 5 weeks, you can check it out right here. It's quite a story with some bumps in the road and who am I kidding? I did fail with that project, but it's well, you should check it out anyway. The link is right here if you guys would like to check that out. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, be sure to hit like, but I will just see you in the next video. That next video. All right, take care. Bye.